So hello and welcome back to our YouTube channel everyone, and we are back with another educational video for all of you. And in today's video I'm going to teach you two very unique trading strategy. One is for intraday purpose, a short term purpose are, and the another one can be used in intraday, but for using it in intraday you really need a higher class of knowledge about the trading. That's why I use that second strategy for midterm trading. Okay, so we have two strategies, one for intraday and another one for our midterm trading. Okay, one thing I would like to request from all of you is that after listening to the video, you should obviously once go and check whatever I have told you with an example. I will tell you definitely with an example, but you should also try it out on any chart of indices or stock. If I say this strategy can be used on indices and stock both, then you can try that on both by yourself. And if I say it can be just used on a stock, then just use that on a stock. If I say this can just be used on indices, then just use it on indices. Okay, but always try to do that by yourself also. Definitely I am going to take examples, and as all of you have requested in the last strategy video that I should not take example of earlier days, but I should take example of the recent days. That's what I'm going to do in this video. I'm going to take example of the recent days, the most date that I'm going to take is 7th and 8th April. I think that's fine. We're standing on the 24th April as I'm recording the video. So 7th and 8th April example is must be okay with all of you. Okay, so now let's start the video. Let's start with our first strategy, which is for the intraday and can be used both on the stock and the indices. So in a daily time frame, at the end of the day, watch, the price should close above the previous day's high. Okay, on a daily time frame you should look that prices should close above the previous day's high. Okay, so now let's try to find out a day where prices have closed above the previous day's high. So let's see, here is the 7th April. So here is the 6th April. As you can see, on 6th April the high was 1426, and on the 7th April the closing was 1430. So yeah, definitely on this day, first requirement of our setup is valid. Okay, the prices must close above the previous day highs. So on 7th April, prices have closed on the 1430, and the 6th April high was 1426. So the first requirement of our setup is now validated. Now the second thing, if you find the buy step on the next day, then when market open, use 5-minute time frame. So what we need to do, we need to use the 5-minute time frame. So let me shift all of you to the 5-minute time frame. So this is 5-minute time frame, little bit too zoomed out because we are using larger time frame, that's why this thing happens. Now let me scroll you back to the our 8th of April day, which is our trading day. Now the first requirement was validated on our 7th of April, and the second requirement, here it is. So we need to go on the 8th April morning opening time. So yeah, here it is, the 8th April morning opening time. So now wait for the 5-minute candle to close above the pivot point. Okay, so now let's apply the pivot strategy. Pivot points standards. Okay, no strategies, no high low, no reversal strategy, just pivot points standard. I'll use it. So here is my 8th of April. First 5-minute candle, it has closed about the pivot point. As you can see, the P is written here. This is the pivot point. It has closed about the pivot line, and you can see the movement then we have got. So here is going to be our entry point, which is 1435, and this is the high made by the prices on that particular day, it was 1452. So you can see 17 points movement we have captured easily. We just, so what we did on the 6th April, prices were closed at 1426. On 7th April we checked prices, on 6th April the prices made a high of 1426, and on the 7th April prices closed above 1426 at 1430. So on 8th April, we saw the first 5 minute candle. If the first 5 minute candle has closed above the pivot point, then we can easily long that particular stock, and we have longed the Infosys and we gained the return of 17 rupees. Maintain a risk reward ratio of 1:2 always. But mostly, you have seen this strategy works very well in this also. If you have not booked the profit here also, then also your stop loss was not triggered and the prices again went high on the next day. So yeah, you can see by this that our risk to reward ratio was not hit and our stop loss was not hit, and we have booked good profit 2 times prices went high. Okay, so this is the condition for going long. Okay, now let's try the setup of going short. So similarly, using this strategy in intraday, you can go short whenever you find that suppose a day prices closed at 100, sorry, made a low of 100, and the next day prices closed below 100, then on the third day you will look at the first 5 minute candle. If that first 5 minute candle closed below the pivot point, then you can short that stock. Let's take an example and understand it. Let's take an example on Infosys itself. So now let's first of all go to the daily time frame. That's very important. We'll try to figure out. Okay. We have to scroll a lot all the time. This is a toughest part of analyzing through these different trading platforms. But what can we do? We have to do it all the time over and over again. So now the second thing is that short position. Okay. So here, so it's 11th, so it's 9th April. The low was 14:30, and then on the 12th April, the closing was 14:25. So the first situation of our trade is validated. The 12th April prices closed below the 9th April's low. So yeah, this first thing is validated. Now second thing is that on the 13th of the April, the first 5 minute candle should close below the pivot point, then we can short sell this stock. So now let's see on the 5 minute chart what has happened. So these are the most recent examples, guys. Right now I'm recording this video on the 21st of April and I'm taking example of 13th and 14th April. So yeah, what better can I do? This is are the most recent examples. Okay, so let's go back, scroll back to the 13th of April and then apply the our pivot point, standard pivot point. So there we go. So this is the starting of the 13th of April trading. So pivot points are standard applied. So yeah, the 13th April first candle closed below this pivot point. Look at the easily written P, so you can identify this is the pivot point closed below this. You can easily short sell the stock here, and then stock went on to made a low here. So the entry point of ours was 1406 and the low it made was 1374. So 30 rupees gain in a day, not in a day, just in an hour. So as you can see how good this strategy works for going long and going short also. So now the reason why I take examples of the Infosys is that Infosys is one of the stock that has high momentum, and this is not the thing that you can only use this strategy with stocks in the high momentum. As we have discussed in the previous strategies video, that there are some strategies in which you need to see the momentum, but in this strategy you do not need to see the momentum. But the thing is that I personally like Infosys. That's why I keep on tricking Infosys so much. That's why most of my examples are from the Infosys only. So for a change, now let's take an example of L&T, which I rarely trade on. That's why I have taken the example of the L&T. So to tell to all of you and to prove that this strategy is not that hard to use and easy to use, and it is very very good, you can easily use that. So the in the L&T also I have taken a recent example of 9th April, so that's not too far away. I hope you can understand. We are standing on the 21th of April, so at least 10-12 days I have to go back. Nope. I can't take example of live market because market are closed. Otherwise, I would have taken those also. So yeah, here we are on the daily time frame. This is Infosys. Now let's change to LT. Larsen & Toubro. And Larsen & Toubro also we have a sales setup. So let's figure it out where it is. So yeah, here on the 9th April you can see the 8th April low was 1410, and the 9th April closing was 1404. So first thing is, now first condition of our short selling is filled up, checkbox had been ticked, and now we have to see the 12th April pivot. So let's move to the 5th of April, 5 minute candlestick. So now let's scroll back a bit to the 12th of April. So yeah, this is the applied. And here you can see this, prices have closed below, this is the pivot point. The first 5 minute candle has closed below the pivot point on the 12th of April, and our setup was validated. We can easily short the stock over here. This is the opening, so 1375, and the low it made was somewhere here, so 1331. So almost 40 points gain in a single day, not in a single day but just in 2.3 hours. So I think that's good enough for all of you. So as you can see how good this strategy works. So I hope this strategy is completely clear with all of you, and use this strategy again and again. Get a surety in your head, then only use it. Okay guys, as you can see, I have given you 3 examples, and all the time this strategy has just worked goodly. I know that not daily you'll find this kind of setup, but if you are a hardcore trader, then if you are tracking 5-10 stocks and indices also, then definitely you'll find it happening on a daily basis or very often. But only if you track some few stocks, like 2-3 stocks, like Infosys, somebody is tracking all the L&T and Infosys like that, then these things will happen in a week or in a 2-week once. But whenever this setup get checkbox ticked on the both of the thing, that the closing thing and the first 5 minute thing, then you'll see amazing results always. So this thing has been proved. I think 3 examples I have taken in the recent examples. Now let's move to the second strategy, which is for the medium term use, and this strategy is only for the going long. Okay, if somebody wants to use it for the short, I will not recommend. I will only tell you to use this strategy to go long. So now for this we need 2 moving averages. Now let's apply 2 moving averages. Moving average number 1. So this is going to be our 240 day weighted, 240 period weighted moving average. Okay, done. And steady again, another moving average. Yeah, another moving average. This is going to be our 21 period Hull moving average. And the color of it is going to be something darker. Okay, done. So now the trade setup is that the 240 period weighted moving average must be sloping up. So here you can see in the Infosys, the 250 day weighted moving average is sloping upward. Okay, first condition is satisfied. And wait, and the 221 period HMA highlights higher high and higher lows. So here it is highlighting higher highs, higher low, again a higher low. Okay, so it is highlighting it. Wait for the HMA to start pulling back downward. So now let me tell you, here is the higher high, here is the higher high and the higher high and the low, and then you can see the HMA was pulling back. Okay, to make a low, and prices have closed above it, so you can long the prices here. So we could have long the prices at 1336, and the results are 1430 or 1455, I think. So 120 points gain easily in few days, obviously in a month, I think. But you can see how this setup works easily. So things to remember is that weighted moving average, 240 weighted moving average must be sloping upward, 21 day Hull moving average must be highlighting higher highs and higher lows. Higher high, higher high, higher high, higher low, higher low, higher low. So now the thing is that this Hull moving average is making right now, it should be higher than this low. And when prices will close above this moving average, then you can go long on the stock. So this is the setup. So I hope all of you have got it. So thank you so much for watching this video, everyone. Please do like this video, share this video with your friends and family, and don't forget to subscribe our channel and press the bell icon to receive such videos on a daily basis. Thank you so much.